Over the past 3 years, I've made a series of tutorials on the OBS software, sharing tons of useful information and free tools on how you could be able to master the software. But there's something I've never done, and that is to share with you some of the tools, the plugin, the script that I use behind the scene to achieve this amazing content you watch here on this YouTube channel, and some of the programs that I've covered in the past. And that is what I'm going to be doing with you in today's tutorial, sharing with you some of the plugins, some of the scripts, some of the tools, just sharing my secrets with you so you could copy it and have them installed on your own OBS software. Remember, it's going to be a long ride. Just buckle up your seatbelt as I take you on this ride with me. Please, I urge you to watch through from the beginning to the end, because that particular section you skip might be where the plugin that will solve your next problem is. Forget to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you haven't, turn on the notification bell, and let's dive in. Starting off is the OBS version that I currently use. I use the OBS 30.2.3, and that is the latest version of the OBS software. And then secondly, what theme do I use to give it this beautiful look you can see right there on the screen? And that's the Leon OBS theme, and that is what I currently use. Go over to the settings here, just click one, you go over to appearance, and you can see the theme here. This is what I currently use. Another tool that I use is the multi-output OBS plugin, which enables me to stream to multiple platforms using the OBS software. You know, by default, you can stream to multiple platforms using the OBS software. With this plugin, you can be able to stream to 4 different platforms, 5 different platforms, 6 or even more using their plugin. Now, remember, you can't do a direct login to this platform. Those platform has to support custom RTMP. If they don't, you won't be able to use the plugin on them. But if they support custom RTMP, like Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, you will be able to use that as well. Now, another amazing plugin that I use, which I love so much, is the Vertical Scenes OBS plugin, which is what you can see right here at the top of the screen. And this plugin is really amazing. It allows me to stream to Facebook and also YouTube on portrait format, even Instagram too on portrait format instead of the landscape. So if I want to do a stream and I want it to be on portrait, I can use this vertical scene here, OBS plugin, to do that. And it also allows me to record the stream, so meaning I can record the stream and at the same time do my live stream to this platform on the portrait format. It's really, really handy. I use it to record my YouTube short and also the shorts that I post on Facebook and different other platforms. Now, another amazing plugin that I also use will be this here. Let me just show you real quick that I use to create this. You're seeing right there on the screen, this camera, a little shadow and the curve. It's actually a plugin that I use in creating that. And the name of that plugin is called Advanced Max. That's what I use to create this. What other OBS tool do I use? And that is the script. This zoom effect script that I use to zoom in and out on OBS. So it's really, really handy, especially if you want to make tutorial, or maybe you have like something you want people to focus on, or something you want to show them. You want to just bring it close, you can zoom in and zoom out. And I use that script to do that. I'm also going to leave the link of that particular script in the description of this video. And by God's grace, I'm also going to make that video as well, explaining a detailed guide on how you can be able to install it on your own OBS Studio. There are actually a lot of them. Now, another tool that I also currently make use of will be the Source Record. Let me show you that real quick. Go over to filters, over to add, and that will be this here on the screen, Source Record. It's really, really handy because it allows you to record your raw video footage that is coming in from your camera on filter. If you use the Source Record to record, all the effect that you're adding on OBS will not reflect on it. So the same quality, the same raw footage that is coming in from your camera is what you are recording. So you don't have any effect or anything on need, so we can be able to work on the clip later. Maybe just add some other effects that you want instead of the effect that you added on the OBS appearing on your clip, which might, you know, disturb your editing process. Now, another tool that I also currently use will be the Manix blur effect here on the screen. I love this a lot because it allows you to blur out your background. As you want to blur out your background, you don't want people to see, you know, where you are, then you can be able to use that to blow out your background. And then also you have the 3D effect here, which is another amazing OBS plugin that you could use to, you know, do some 3D effect on your OBS video. Another amazing tool that I also use will be the AI Remove BG. Now you can use this to remove your background on OBS. You just use it to automatically remove your background on the OBS software. Now, even if you don't have any green screen on, you can be able to use it to remove your background on OBS. Now, you can add a custom background to it, or maybe blow out your background. It's really, really handy, especially if you don't use any green screen, but you still want to be able to remove your background on OBS. And then another OBS tool that I also use as well will be the Teleport. So with the Teleport plugin, you don't need the NDI tools. All you just have to do is just turn on the plugin, and then you can be able to use it to send out your OBS output to different PCs that you have. You can send it out to multiple PCs, okay? And then maybe you'll be record on one and then do other things on the other ones as well. And that is why the Teleport plugin is really, really handy. I made a detailed guide on it, which I'm also going to drop the link in the description of this video. So go ahead and check that out. And one other plugin that I also use will be the Move Transition plugin, which enables me to, you know, have like this smooth movie effect. That's it. In case I want to, like, you know, do some transition, I can be able to do that. I kind of love it really, really well. Give the video a thumbs up if you find it helpful, and let me know. And don't also forget that I've dropped the consultation link in the description of this video, so you could also use that to reach out to me for a private consultation session with me.